Hey guys, I'm Lucy, mama to two boys. Charlie is 4 and Noah is almost 2. Today I wanted to talk about potty training and beyond. What happens after the first week of potty training? What are the issues that I've been dealing with Noah? And what does it look like to have your child fully potty trained? If you're new, I would love it if you would stick around and subscribe. I post mommy videos on just anything that can help you get through your everyday as a mom. I like to be real and show you exactly the issues that I'm dealing with as a mom at that moment. So I hope you will stick around and subscribe to my channel. Potty training. People don't normally talk about potty training after the first week. Normally it's like, I potty trained my kid in 3 days. It's a little more complicated than that. Potty training after the first week, what does it look like? And when do you call your kid potty trained? When is that like the title you get to use? If you're having any trouble with your child that you've potty trained and you're like, why is my kid still having accidents? Is my kid actually potty trained? Did I do something wrong? If any of these are questions that you're having, then stay tuned and we will get into it. I am by no means an expert. I am just a mom. I have 2 boys and I potty trained them both before they turned 2. So I have a little bit of experience, but definitely not a potty training expert by any stretch of the imagination. To potty train both my boys, I use the Oh Crap potty training method. I highly recommend that book. She's hilarious and just to the point and very simple, and it's a very quick read. When I was potty training my first son, Charlie, I had read that book and we went through the process and I was like, okay, Charlie, he's potty trained. This is great. But it didn't look how I thought it would look. I thought when a child is potty trained that they wouldn't have any accidents. They'd be, you know, using the toilet all the time. And potty trained means when you no longer have accidents, right? I mean, that's intuitively what you would think it means. But I encourage you to view potty training a little bit differently. So in my mind, potty training is when your child is using the toilet most of the time and accidents are still a part of their life. Charlie is 4, he's gonna be turning 5 in August, and he is pretty much never having accidents now. Maybe once in a blue moon he'll have one at night or he'll have one during the day, but for the most part he's like done. So at 2 years old and 3 years old, potty training shouldn't look like no accidents ever. Having that expectation that potty training does not mean no accidents is very important. Another thing that I didn't know when I first started out was that you should really treat potty training at night and daytime separately. So your child can be fully potty trained during the day and still wear diapers at night, and that's okay. You can do them separately. You can definitely do them together, but separately is fine, and you can still call your kid potty trained as long as they're potty trained during the day. That makes sense. Okay, so how to handle pushback, behavioral issues around the potty. In that first week, there comes a time when you have to actually step back and hand over control to your child.
I'll put your boots on. Your potty's here if you need it.
Make them the master of their own potty training, if that makes sense. If you don't give them that opportunity to make it their own, then they will either become helpless and they'll need you for everything, or they're gonna show resistance and not wanna do it. So that's essential, to give them that freedom and opportunity to do it themselves. And it's really hard because it's pee all over your floor. You have to act like you don't care even though you really do care. And so later in potty training, similar things can happen. You can come up against resistance or even purposeful peeing, which we're dealing with right now with Noah, or a child becoming overconfident where they think they've got it figured out, and so they wait too long to go to the potty. They keep playing instead of going right when they feel that urge, and so they end up having an accident. There are a number of reasons why your child may be having accidents later on in potty training, but the main thing to remember is that you don't really need to know why. Which is lucky, because it's really hard to figure out what's going on in a toddler's mind. But you don't need to know why they're doing what they're doing. All you need to do is keep doing what you're doing. Don't question yourself. Stay calm and firm with your boundaries. What we like to do with Noah is we will say, no pee on the floor, your pee goes in the potty. We also prompt Noah at transition times. Before he has a meal, we will say, first go potty and then you have your dinner. First go potty and then we'll go to granny's house. You're telling him this needs to happen first and then we will go. You're not saying, if you go potty, we'll go to granny's, because that is bribery. It's that balance between giving him his own power over himself and then also making sure that he goes when you need him to go. What we're dealing with right now with Noah, which prompted me to make this video, is that anytime I put him in his crib, he is just peeing. And we've just been in the bathroom, he's just gone pee. So he's peeing because he doesn't want to be alone, he doesn't want to nap, and he knows I'll come back in. So that's a behavioral issue. That's not an issue with potty training. That's an issue with his behavior. And so really just staying firm. I don't get him out of his room when he does this. I change his sheets. I say, no pee pee in your crib. Pee pee goes in the potty. We already went pee pee, so you need to hold it for your nap. You know, I tell him that. I change his sheets, give him a snuggle, and he goes back in. Potty training can look like different things for different kids, and that's okay. As long as you feel like you're getting most of the pee and poop in the potty and you feel good about it and you feel confident, then that's what potty training is. And it'll get better and better and better over time. I think that's everything, you guys. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. And I really appreciate you watching. I hope this was helpful. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.